Just a real quick video here, or this is April 3rd. There's a lot of buzz going on about what in the world? Alien disclosure. And it's very likely that's going to happen. They say it's going to happen in England, London. President Clinton was, apparently on television talking to one of those talk show people and talking about aliens, and he said, I wouldn't be surprised if there are, wouldn't surprise me at all. And they said, and they asked him, well, if you knew, you would tell us, right? And he looked down the ground and said, oh, yeah. He was lying, of course. I mean, those of us who know Clinton know when he's lying, which is most of the time, but he's definitely lying there. He could tell. Can't fool us. After having 8 years of him, we know when he's lying. And so he knows about the ET situation, and it's just coming out right now. People over in England are reporting that they've been prepped for this through the advertisements. The way that people get prepped for what's going to happen is actually through commercials and, to some extent, the content on the shows. It's really interesting. The content on shows is actually a commercial for the commercials. It gets you to watch the commercials. That's actually why television works, is the shows get you to watch the commercials. The commercials are where the real message is on television. And apparently, by those people over in England, Great Britain, they say that they're just super saturated, and the commercials are totally about aliens. Aliens are just being used in so many commercials. It's just like, what is going on? Everything is you know, toilet paper, aliens. You know, everything's aliens. Of course, they're getting people ready for aliens. The Vatican is doing that also, and of course. This is the time when two different futures open up. Which future are you going to go? And one of the things that has happened over the last 50 years is prepping for contact with aliens and trying to get people to help prep the world for that, so that we can normalize and adjust to their agenda, their ways of doing things, all this tolerance for people who are very different than us. You know, it's all about aliens, actually. A lot of stuff's going on. The pyramids that were discovered in Crimea, just where the Russians invaded and took over and now fortified everything. These world's oldest pyramids, they're so old they've become buried in sediment, completely buried. The whole thing is about, okay, what future now do you choose? It's time to choose. Are you going to go with the alien a future where high technology, all the stuff supposedly they're going to supply to us in the future, make this world a great place, etc.? Or are you going to go in a future of right spiritual practice? That's the difference. Now, let's say there's a garbage dump and they've just got everything in the world there, junk, garbage. And let's say you stretched stretched a band of gold over the entire garbage dump. The whole thing was covered with this beautiful lustrous gold, shining, just so beautiful. Now, and you're looking at this gold and say, wow, that really reminds me of something. It reminds me of my home. Yeah, it reminds me of the light of my home. How wonderful. Now, does it really matter? Do we need to take inventory of the garbage underneath the gilded, the gold? Do we need to know how much? Do we need to measure it? Do we need to rearrange it? Do we need to clean it, the stuff under the gold? No, it doesn't really matter what's under the gold, does it? It doesn't matter in the slightest bit. We don't need to do anything. We don't need to sort the garbage out. We don't need to sort it out. We don't need to pressure wash it. We don't need to spray perfume on it. We don't need to do anything with the garbage dump. Nothing at all. Just let it be exactly as it is. That's not what's important. It's what overlays the garbage dump that reminds us of our true home, okay, where there is no garbage at all. That is the key. So that can be your future too. That is the future that Jesus has suggested to us. And of course, this whole thing about the two different futures is the sheep and the goat separation. We know that. And it's here. It's here now. Very interesting. My life is set, completely set up to decide at this point, because I don't have any future. In the traditional timeline that we're on, my future has ended. And so I completed the last task of my job yesterday and don't have anything else going forward, really. Not really. And so, it's just a decision time. Now, The ETs try to recruit everybody to help normalize the world to them so they can come here. They think they're bringing salvation to the world, enlightenment, etc. And of course, they tried to recruit me. And of course, I was trying to figure out what's going on. You know, is this the right thing or not? So I'm very much aware of you know, the overall picture of the whole situation, what you have to choose between. They want people who can associate with them up close and take video, interview them, the whole nine yards, roll them out, the whole big, you know, rolling out party of the ETs here on this planet. And they wanted me to help them do that. And I said, no, I decided no. Of course, it's very glamorous. People will think that you're very special if you're in with the ETs, right? You're in with them, and you're able to communicate with them, and know what they want and telepathically, and all these kinds of stuff. You'll be special. You'll be important. You'll be have a big estate and all this kind of stuff. But no, it's like selling your soul to the devil. Why do that? It's a complete waste of time. It has nothing to do with enlightenment. ETs have nothing to do with enlightenment. They're just as clueless as we are, if not more so, actually. If not more so, because they're further down the rabbit hole of technology. And they don't understand what salvation really is. It is the vision of oneness. It is, salvation is within. The kingdom of heaven is within. It's not external. It's within. It's, kingdom of heaven is not form-based. It's idea-based. Ideas don't take up any space. The kind of space that we think of, okay, they exist in pure spaciousness. Ideas and essence exist in, has its being in pure spaciousness, which is not the kind of spaciousness that we're seeing and perceiving right now. So this overlay of the lovely living light of God's remembrance of God, remembrance of our home, overlaying anything, like it's gilded, everything is gilded with this presence. Okay, gilded with this presence. That is salvation. And nothing is excluded, and nothing is judged or anything. Just like gold, gilded, a whole garbage dump being overlaid by this beautiful lake of gold, for instance, let's say. It doesn't matter what's underneath it. It's only the light that reminds us of reality. That's God's plan of salvation. The ETs do not know God's plan of salvation. They don't. I've had many interactions with ET mindset, and I've tested them out. They're ignorant, they're clueless. They think it comes through technology and economic plans and plans of making sure everybody has the right distribution and the right job, and they think they can, you know, micromanage everything. You know, and they have this belief that they know better than humans know. So, well, that's all relative. You know, it's the non-relative overlaying the relative. The non-relative doesn't judge the relative. It just says, that's all delusion. It's all delusion. It's all denial of the non-relative. It's a denial, that's all. So it just overlays the denial. So you're reminded of the truth. It doesn't judge the denial or anything. Just like you don't judge the garbage dump, this lake of gold overlaying a garbage dump. It's not judging, well, there's some walnut shells there, and there's some coffee grounds, and there's some old pipe there, and, well, I kind of like the this, that, and that. No, it just overlays all of it equally. Doesn't judge anything, the garbage dump at all. Doesn't matter. Doesn't have to sort it out. Doesn't have to change anything, rearrange anything. Say, oh, let me move these coffee grounds over here. There's some eggshells there. I don't like the eggshells. Let's put them over here. And there's some old paper towels and some orange rinds. And there's a broken old trash, you know, waste basket. Let's repaint that. Let's recycle that waste basket. Let's change how it looks. The orange rinds, let's chop them up a little bit. Nothing has to happen to the garbage dump in order for it to be overlaid by this beautiful light. And that light reminds us of home. We're not looking at what's underneath the light, so to speak. It's not important. It doesn't have the quality of remembrance to it, so it's useless. It's useless. If something's useless, we're not going to worry about it. It has no meaning, it's useless, no value. It's the overlay of this light that has value. That's salvation. Salvation has nothing to do with the ETs. Nothing to do with the ETs at all. Okay. So this is just a heads up. Decision for your future is now going to be arrived. Where, you know, what do you think your future, where your emphasis and your valuing should be? and it's going to, it's likely to be, you know, in a day or two, or you know, very soon, stuff is going to happen, and you'll feel that you need to make a decision which way to go. It's very simple. God's plan of salvation is very simple, very easy. You can be clued into it, and just a little bit of work at it, you'll start to say, ah, okay, it's not so tough at all. All right, very great. I'll get this one up here and see what's next. That's it.